All right then, let me just take the next one, which rallies around the U.S. restriction on visas. Yes, the United States has announced it's expanding its curb on immigration to include 6 more countries, including Nigeria, Africa's most populous nation. Now, citizens from Nigeria, Eritrea, Sudan, Tanzania, Kazakhstan, and Myanmar will now be blocked from obtaining certain types of visas. However, people from these countries will still be able to visit the United States as tourists. Now, according to the United States government statistics, the State Department issued 8,018 immigrant visas to Nigerians in the fiscal year of 2018. Now, in 2018, the U.S. issued twice as many immigration visas to Nigerians than to the other 5 nations combined. All right, so still on this, you know, conversation, Nigeria seems to be, you know, on the global eye now. So on this particular restriction issue, what was your initial reaction when you saw, you know, the news?
Well, if you, it's very hard to really make sense of this in an objective way, because if you look at the Nigerian diaspora in the United States, they're among the most successful diaspora. They're better educated than the average American. They earn more than the average American. They're in industry. There are many of the professors, medical professionals. They're doing extremely well. So if you think even about the President Trump's stated objective of getting high quality immigrants into the United States, Nigeria should be at the top of the list. And then from a security viewpoint, I'm not an expert, but as far as I can tell, there hasn't been a Nigerian national. I mean, we have our own security challenges, as the news highlighted, but there hasn't been a Nigerian national for a very long time. There was an incident maybe 7 or 8 years ago with the, I believe, the shoe bomber. It was Nigerian, but there hasn't, and yet at the same time you have an ally, Saudi Arabia, where one of the people that the U.S. military trains, you know, killed several people a few months ago. And so now we have Nigeria, which is not exporting terror to the United States, which but is exports very high quality people to the United States, getting hit with this ban, and it just seems a little bit strange.
And do you see this potentially affecting our bilateral trade between Nigeria and the United States?
I don't think it'll affect the bilateral trade. I mean, business people look beyond this, and I mean, over a longer period, I guess we'll have fewer Nigerians in the United States, so less chance for connectedness. But I have to believe sometime, I hope, in the short period, this gets reversed, because it really doesn't, when you compare it to the other, you know, the stated intention, it just doesn't square up right now what the United States has done. But of course, in my own country, home country, Canada, we continue to take a lot of high-quality, well-educated professional Nigerians. They're doing very well in Canada. Maybe these 8,000 that would have gone to the United States will come to Canada.
To Canada.
Now.
All right, and finally, before just before we go, how would this potentially affect Nigerian businesses? Do you see any?
Well, I think the American businessman sort of would look beyond this. If they want to deal with a Nigerian business, they'll deal with a Nigerian business. I think that what's critical for Nigerian business too is to remember that Nigeria should have commercial ties with everyone in the world. So we last, yes. I guess 2 weeks ago now, we had the UK-Africa summit. The UK with Brexit is very focused on Africa, very focused on Nigeria. Europeans, the German, Italian, French companies very focused on Africa. The Russians had at the Afra-Exim Bank conference.
Everybody seems to be having
India,
an African summit.
So I think for Africa and Nigeria to develop, you know, we need to have commercial relations with everyone. And pick and choose what's best for Africa in these commercial relationships. So I think it's an issue, but I don't think it'll set back that agenda too far. But I think it's unfortunate for those Nigerians who wanted to go to the United States, were qualified to go to the United States, that process for now has come to an end.